this program is really also recognizing the power of the arts, and I'd like to bring on Jackie Davis. We have been working on how do we make the kinds of changes that we care about and the importance that the arts can play in this. Over to you, Jackie.
Thanks, Rachel, and hi, everyone. When One Shared World was created about a year and a half ago, it was understood that arts and culture would be central to our efforts. What do arts and culture have to do with climate change, systemic poverty, sanitation, and clean water for all? Culture is the centrifugal force that embodies and inspires humanity in all of us. We're so proud to announce the incredible artists who have become global artists for One Shared World. They include Alan Cumming, Scottish actor, Arwa Gouda, Egyptian film star, Youssou Ndour, Senegalese musician, Arturo O'Farrell, Latin jazz pianist and big band leader, and Sting, rock star. Now to you, Rachel, for the rest of the list.
Well, we also have Julie Taymor, the extraordinary director of film and theater, Lin Hwai-Min, the choreographer who has inspired so many of us from Taiwan, Sharmeen Obaid-Chinoy from Pakistan, who has made incredibly inspiring films, the Kronos Quartet, in recognition of their One Shared World in terms of bringing new voices to the quartet, and of course, the extraordinary Renee Fleming. And we're really delighted to be able to invite Renee here. Thank you so much for being here, Renee. And we'll have a moment to talk a little bit about some of the extraordinary work that you have been doing. This has included the new recording that is about to come out, The Voice of Nature, the Anthropocene, which I think really captures both the challenges of the times that we're living in, and at the same time, the transformative power that I think music can bring us. And I'd love to hear from you, Renee, a little bit more about your vision on how, what is it that music and the arts can do that that really in some ways other forms of communication can't.
Thank you, Rachel. It's great to see you and Jackie as well. So I kind of experienced this firsthand throughout my life of touring and meeting audiences where they are and seeing this power exhibited in how people respond to music. And it got me interested in neuroscience. So that's been the thing I think that's really taking up so much of my attention and passion at the moment. And one of the things I learned while as I explore this intersection of science and the arts is that evolution is really the key. That music and the arts, whether in use of voice or drumming or any of these kind of tribal influences have been an extraordinary driver of community for millennia now. I mean, for so much longer than recorded history. And we don't change that quickly. So that's one thing that's been very clear as well. And the thing that I think really works, that sparks empathy, that sparks change, and it's something, of course, we need a lot more of at the moment, is emotion. And emotion and memory are very strongly tied together, but that cathartic moment when we feel something that drives change and that drives us to do something together and to cooperate.
You know, you have really focused on this idea of the Anthropocene, and I think so much of this is about the collective, and yet some of it is quite intimate, like the program you've been doing on breathing. So there's something that is both the intimacy of breath, which we all have, and the kind of transformative power that sharing music with a group of people has, as you just stated.
Well, the Voice of Nature, this recording that I'm releasing in a couple of weeks, was spurred by the horrors of the pandemic, being at home, being grounded. All of us as artists and performing in the performing arts were completely grounded. And so many people were struggling out of work, not able to make ends meet. It's been a really tragic time for us, as well as for so many other people. And I think my saving activity was being out in nature, was walking, was being outside. I really wanted to be outside all day. I didn't want to come inside. It was almost an obsession with me. You know, I started biking, etc. And so, and I think Mother Nature has our attention now. I mean, certainly the kind of catastrophic weather issues we're having in the U.S. have really just completely taken over the news for the most part in recent months. So I thought, what can we do as artists? And I always think about how powerful nature was in the 19th century in poetry. Every human condition, every human experience was framed through the lens of nature. Love, loss, tragedy, you name it, it was all nature. And so that, I thought, let's juxtapose that with our relationship to nature now. What's happening now? So we have two new commissions and three young composers on the album who really look at some of the issues that we're facing right now. And you know, I keep saying Mother Nature's been very good to us. We haven't been very good to Mother Nature, so we need to work on that. So that's that piece. But Healing Breath with Google Arts and Culture has really struck a chord. That was another way in which I thought, how can we help long COVID patients? And we singers are experts on breathing. It's what we train to do. It's what we're almost like swimmers in the sense that we have to have a sustained, controlled breath to do what we do. And so I just reached out to 14 friends and said, please share your breathing secrets. So and sing a little bit so we can give some hope and some strategies to long COVID patients.
Thank you. Can we now hear you in a piece that has come from this new collection that will be out in a couple of weeks?
Yes, yes. This is Yannick Nézet-Séguin playing the piano. He is the music director of the Metropolitan Opera, and we recorded this last April.